Greetings, Pittsburgh Sports Now diehards. I hope everybody's doing well. Wanted to give a few brief thoughts on the new look for Pitt. I was in attendance with my family. I actually got on KDKA News with my youngest son when we were raiding the Nike shop on Sunday. We attended the reveal. Was able to see up front, up close, the uniforms, and I was able to purchase an obscene amount of swag. Just to give some perspective here, I think it's about time that Pitt went to something like this. For years, we have had a schizophrenic athletic department when it came to messaging. My chief complaint over the last 20 years, and you could go back and you could blame the various administrations, in particular Steve Peterson, you would walk the streets and we went from Pitt to Pittsburgh, block Pitt, scorched Pitt, for those to remember that, script Pitt, dino cat, hyena dog, or whatever the derivation was after that. It looked like an angry chipmunk. You would walk around the streets and you would see 20 different configurations of Pitt clothing. I cannot tell you how much I have donated because I've tried to stay on top of the trends and it becomes exhausting and you spend a lot of money. That Pitt script, the colors, it's your brand, it's your image. I could be here, I could be in Hawaii, or I could be in Japan. And if I see that Pitt script, and now if I see this guy, I should be able to automatically identify the University of Pittsburgh. Heather Like made a brilliant move. You look at what your fan base wants to buy, and you sit there and you look at the rest of the country, and in particular the ACC, and ask yourself, do we stand out? My sons have always said this. You look at Georgia Tech, look at Notre Dame. Used to be WVU, it changed up a little bit. All of the colors blended in. Not that they weren't appealing, they blended in. When Pitt went to the retros, what you saw was your fan base gravitate towards the retro colors. They were vibrant, they went hand in hand with tradition, and they stood out. Heather Like saw that, and 2 years ago jumped on that and went to the Knight design team. I'm a Knight guy. I'm going to be the first to tell you this, if you can't tell. I'm bullish on Nike and their design team. I knew they would knock it out of the park. If I could also recommend, I just finished Phil Knight's Shoe Dog, one of the single best business memoirs I've ever read, bar none. Buy it tomorrow and you'll thank me later. But back to the uniforms. I love what they did. I love the look. I think it's distinctive. I think it's vibrant. I've heard some of the complaints with the lettering, and I've heard some of the complaints with the colors of the lettering, and I get it. They're not going to be flawless, but overall, I think they knocked it out of the park. As you see, I swagged out pretty heavily. It's important to note that my family was one of the first in line for the opening of the Nike store. My sons were clamoring for gear. I nearly dropped $1,000, and that's not an exaggeration. If you're on KDK and you see my face, it looks glazed over because they told me the price of what we spent. But I joked around on my Twitter feed. I call it the Pitt Swag Apocalypse. But we love the new look. We love the new gear. What I like about it, it says Pitt. Traditional, to me, the traditional Pitt colors with a bit more pop. Two, when you think of what solidifies university, the foundation of the University of Pittsburgh, you go right to the Cathedral of Learning. I will not refer to it as Cathy, although I guess I just did. The Cathedral of Learning, to me, epitomizes the University of Pittsburgh. It's our home base. So the fact that they were able to pull the angles, pull the panther head off that giant facility and integrated into the uniforms, to me, is absolutely brilliant. So Sunday, to me, is a Pitt fan and someone that's covered it for 20 years online, and you all have heard me in some way, shape, or form, was a very meaningful day because it's something that needed to happen. And one of the beautiful things, when I talked to Heather Lake briefly, she mentioned, we're staying with this. It's not going anywhere. I won't have to rebuy gear and throw this out a year from now. That's a beautiful thing. Your branding is your identity. Your branding is your identity, your credo. It's everything. It's what you stand for. So it's beautiful that she was able to cultivate and put all that together. This is a feather in Heather Like's cap. It's going to be a feather in her legacy, which is far from over, because there's going to be significant changes moving in the future. But I just want to address that I'm elated with what's going on. I also want to add this. My sons were amongst the first in Pittsburgh to walk around with this guy on their shirts. I came back, and I know this is impromptu. I asked them, what did they think when you showed up at school? They were surrounded. The kids love it. If you want to get that younger demographic and sell to that younger demographic as well, they like what they saw. They like the gear that they saw. You know, right now, people like me, people like you, we're diehards. We're not going to go anywhere. You got to build that fan base. I think this new color scheme, the new gear that's out there, is very catchy, and I think it's going to catch that younger demographic and hopefully get more butts at Heinz Field and at the Pete. So everyone, Sunday was great. I loved it. I hope you like the uniforms as well. I'd love to hear from you on Twitter. Take care.